What's up, everybody? So, the last vlog that I put out, I was talking to you guys about trying to do a schedule and maybe bringing you guys into my life a little bit more. And usually when I do these videos, like this driving, it's because that's when I have the most time. Because I don't have the kids with me or my wife with me, or I'm not at work, which I work a lot, not on YouTube. And that's where I'm coming back from today. I got a customer in Anniston, Alabama, and that's where I'm driving back from. So it's like a 3.5 hour drive from my house one way. I still got about an hour and a half, hour and 15 minutes left. I'm just driving through the mountains now. You can see, I don't know if you can turn that much, and it won't, but oh, it's because of the, oh my. Let's see if you guys can see the, I just went down into like a little gully thing, but well, anyways, it was worth a shot. But anyways, so now the sun's like right on me. Well, it looks like I'm in the witness protection program. So, so I'm gonna try to do more where I'm carrying the camera around, and my man Carlos even said something about maybe vlogging when I'm doing videos, which is a good idea. Maybe I'll do like some behind the scenes type vlogs where I show you guys how I set up and maybe a little bit of editing, stuff like that, but still keeping it vlog style. But aside from the tech type of stuff, I think I'm gonna start trying to share more, I guess, personal stuff with you guys so you guys can get to know me a little bit better. I don't know how well this is looking, because from what I can tell, it looks like I'm all blacked out except for like this area here. But so like things that I don't know, some people know about me and some people don't, but like yesterday, I'm pretty heavily involved in my church, and last night we had a meeting about like the children's ministry. It's sort of the pastor gets together with all the different people who, you know, whether it's a Sunday school teacher or I work with the youth, which is 12 to 18 or 12 to 17, but we had some conversation and, you know, just how's everybody doing, different ideas. And my wife and I have been talking about some different ideas that we've been wanting to sort of present at the church. And but they have something called Safe Sanctuary, where it's just, I don't know, sort of like rules for making sure that our kids are safe and making sure that, you know, when they're at the church, they're safe. And any kids that come to visit, we have, my wife and I have ran VBS for the last couple of years, and we do stuff with that. So, I mean, we're really involved, and we have young children, obviously, that go to that church, and all of our friends have young children that go to that church. So it's something that we're really passionate about. So last night, part of that meeting was talking about Safe Sanctuary, and I wasn't involved in it before, whatever, but I sort of volunteered to sort of head that up. So that's something that'll be taking some of my time now, is you know, just implementing different things, making sure things are being followed. And but those are the kind of things that I enjoy. I love working with the kids at church, and I think I'm going to start working with the middle age kids. Like, we have usually have like three age groups. And there's the youngest, which is what Miles and Sawyer are in, which is like 5 and under or 6 and under. And then we have like a 7 to 11. And that's the age group I'm going to start working with and teaching. So at least on like a Wednesday night deal. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty exciting to me. I know maybe it bores you guys, but like I said, I'm going to start trying to get a little bit more personal with my vlog. So I'm gonna try to not just keep it to tech. Trust me, tech is probably, I don't know. It's a big chunk of my life when it comes to things that I enjoy, things that I read about and research and look at and things like that. But the biggest part of my life is church and family. So that's something that, you know, I'm not going to bring. I don't think I'll bring the vlog camera to church or anything, or, you know, maybe it'll be more, you know, but it'll just be, if I'm going to share with you guys what I do, this is what I do. This is who I am. So, I want to get more on a personal level with you guys and not just, you know, talking tech. But that being said, this is what you call, now that I do the podcast with Mike, this is what you call in the business a segue. And to segue into tech, I bought a new microphone. I just got the email a little while ago that it shipped from Amazon. I ordered the microphone and then the shock mount for it. I use right now the Rode NT1, and I love it. I love the way it sounds. It's what I use for my voiceovers. It's what I use when I'm doing my unboxings, if I'm doing live audio as I'm unboxing. And I think I've had a lot of compliments over the last couple weeks about my audio. So I really love the audio that comes from that mic. But one issue that I have is when I do the podcast, it's like a side condenser mic, so it needs to be upright. So in the podcast, I have it like right off to the side here. And it sounds fine and there's no real issue, but I wanted to get like a podcaster type mic. And I looked at the Rode Podcaster mic, which is like the white, but it's a USB, and I really like having the XLR option. And so I went with the Procaster, which is the same exact price, but it's an XLR mic. I think the Podcaster has headphone monitoring right on the mic, so you can plug right into the mic and listen, but right now I'm using the Scarlett 2i2, but I may even be getting rid of that and just use my H5 as a USB interface and plug that directly into my computer, and then my Procaster, Rode Procaster, into that, and then monitor the audio that way. I like the Scarlett 2i2, but you don't have any, I don't want to say fine adjustment, but there's no levels. I'm sure I could pull a program up to where I could see them or whatever, but I like as easy as possible for me. It just has a red light. A red circle light, or a light that's circular around the gain knob that is green if you're good, and it'll turn red if you're getting too high and cutting. So I would like to more be able to see the audio levels, which I can with my H5. So I think with the podcast this week, which I believe Mike and I are doing on Wednesday because he's going out of town again this weekend, I'm going to try that, and the Procaster will be in tomorrow. So I'm going to try those two. I'm not even going to address that I'm yawning now, but I mean, this is a really long drive. It's been a really long day. I left the house at 6 in the morning, and it is now almost 6 o'clock in the evening, and the majority of my day has been driving, so forgive the yawns. But anyway, so I'm going to try that, and hopefully that works out, and then I may keep the NT1 just on my unboxing desk for doing that. But I believe Dom from Mac Mixing uses the Procaster for all of his, I think he did an office setup tour, and I believe he uses that for all his voiceover and everything. So it'll be, I'm hoping the audio quality on it is just as good, because I would like to use it on my computer setup for the podcast and for voiceover. And then I'd like to keep the other microphone over on the unboxing table just so I don't have to bring it back and forth. And anybody that has watched any of my videos in the past where I talk about different things that I do, for me, the biggest thing, like Tomas said on our podcast, I can't remember the word he used, but to me, simplicity. So anything that makes it easier for me to do my workflow, my videos. I don't have much time to do videos because of, like I said, I have church, I have my family, I have the kids, I have a job that I work a lot. I don't have the time that somebody that does it full-time has, or even, you know, some guys, that they're able to do it a lot more than myself. Me, I need it to be as quick and painless as possible. So I'm willing to spend a couple extra dollars to do things to make it easier. So maybe if the Procaster mic sounds really, really good, I'll sell my NT1 and then buy another Procaster mic, and I'll have one on the unboxing station, the table, the overhead setup for when I'm doing that, and then also have the one that's permanently mounted by the computer for podcasting and voiceover there, so I have the same mic for everything I do, so there's some consistency in the audio. You know, I think audio is probably close to like your video, where you would be able to tell the difference if I shoot, you know, one angle with a Nikon camera and then another one with a Canon. I mean, I don't know, maybe you could, maybe you couldn't, but I would rather there be some flow to it. But I'm willing to spend that extra money just so I don't have to take, like right now when I do the podcast, I have to take the microphone off the whole arm and everything, off the unboxing table, which isn't that big of a deal, it's just a clamp, but, and then I gotta bring it over to my other desk where my computer is and where the webcam is, and then, you know, get ready. So, you know, anything I can do to make it easier, I'm gonna do. So some of the other stuff going on, I upgraded my internet to 100 up, 100 down, woohoo! I found out, I went to go pay the bill, and found out that for some reason, I don't remember when I got internet hooked up. I mean, I know it was about 2 years ago, but I don't remember it, you know what I'm saying? So when I went in there, I'm like, well, what do I have? Because I was paying like 55 bucks a month. And I assumed when I looked at the thing that I had, I don't know what it was, 30 down, 15 up, or something like that. I assumed that's what I had because that was a $55 package. But the lady's like, no, you have... 15 up three, or 15 down three up. And I'm like, oh no. So I was paying $55 a month. It was a $40 package plus a $15 service fee every month. And the more you go up, they drop the service fee off. So I went up to 100 up, 100 down. It's fiber. It's locally owned by the town. It's called Light Tube. It's in Tullahoma, Tennessee. And it's locally owned, I think because we have an Air Force base, and I don't know, there's something, but 100 up, 100 down is $79 a month, and that's everything. That's, there's no like connection fee for the month when you go that high. And for 200 up and 200 down, it's only 200, it's $20 more, it's $99 a month. So to me, that's an unbelievably good deal. So, you know, with YouTube, I think I uploaded a video over the weekend. What was it? Oh, the LG G3 zebra skin wrap, zebra wood wrap from slickwraps.com. And it was a 5 or 6 minute video, but it literally took me 5 minutes to upload to YouTube. Whereas before, obviously, because I had super crappy connection, it took forever. The only issue that I have now is because I'm Wi-Fi in my office, I'm only getting like 60 up, I think, or 60 down and 50 some up, which is still great, but I want to take full advantage of my 100-100. So I have to run a hard wire up into the office, which is above the garage, so it shouldn't be that bad, but my garage is completely finished, all drywalled, but I think I'm gonna do that this weekend. And then the other thing is the Ethernet that they have running through the house, somehow when they built the house, they daisy chained it. I didn't have the house built, but the guy explained to me when we moved in that it's daisy chained. So we're going to pull all those wires into the garage and set up a switch so they're all individual. And then from that switch, I'll run a wire up the ceiling and then into my office so I can get that full 100-100. And then what I'll do in my office is I will put another switch up there, and run hardline Ethernet to my computer, my Xbox One, my PlayStation 4, my Apple TV, just hardwire everything. So, yeah, so I'm pretty excited about the 100-100. I just got to get it going. Big shout out to Ryan, Ryan Rigg from Fast Electronic and Loud. Him and I were talking. I think he mentioned it on one of his vlogs that how we were talking last Friday. I think it was Friday or Thursday about that, how I needed to upgrade. So he's going to help me. He gave me some direction to go with that, so I appreciate the help. So yeah, that's what, here, let me see if you guys can see this. I love this part of the drive. You like got the sides of the, so you're not really, let me pop you out. Like the roads like cut into the mountain. And this is like about an hour away from my house. See a big bug on the window, the windshield. I don't know, you don't get the full effect from the camera, but it's a beautiful drive, and I love this part of the country. Ever since we moved out about 4 years ago, there's not one complaint I have about living in Tennessee or living in the South when it comes to, you know, the views and the different things like that. It's just awesome. So, but anyways, guys, this is a little bit longer, but I'm going to try to get, I'm still not 100% sure what I'm going to do about scheduling for videos, but I'm definitely working on figuring out what schedule will work for me and what will be the future in scheduling and vlogs and things like that. But I believe if I'm going to bring you guys a little bit more into my life, it shouldn't be that hard to vlog. I'm going to try to vlog semi-daily, so hopefully this one, whether I post them the day of, like I said before, I don't know, maybe I'll post them the next day to give me a little bit of a buffer, but if I complete a vlog like today, it's 6 o'clock, and by the time I get home, it's 7, yeah, I won't go up today, you know, I can, because the vlogs, I don't do any editing, I just do straight from my RX100 M3, pop the card into my, you know, depending on if I'm at home, but if I'm at work, you know, during lunch or some free time, I'll pop it in real quick, throw it in a Final Cut, and then just make sure the audio's good, give that up or down adjustment, and then boom, send it right to compressor, and that's it. So I mean, it literally can take 2 minutes to start the compressor, and then on my MacBook Air. And then it takes a while for compressor on there, depending on how long the video is. I mean, this one's going to be close to 20 minutes, so it'll take a little while. But then I'll get that going, and then, you know, if that's done by lunchtime, I'll start the upload process at lunchtime, let it run in the background on my laptop for the rest of the day. And then usually it'll finish by the time I go home, you know, it'll be done by the time I leave the office, you know, 5, 6 o'clock, whatever time it is. And then if not, then I just open my laptop when I get home and let it finish when I get home. So, all right, well, that's gonna be about it, guys. I appreciate you guys watching as always, and like I said, more vlogs coming, more consistency on the channel, and make sure you guys are watching the OG podcast with me and at MTP Flyers on Twitter, Mike. So it's a lot of fun, and like I said, this week, by the time you guys see this, I'll probably post this on Wednesday, so it'll be coming Wednesday night, I believe 8:30 Eastern is when we're going to be doing it, and it's on iTunes if you guys just want to check out the audio. But some of the stuff we do, I mean, we chat for a little while before we officially start the podcast, which is what we record and what we put out on video and audio, and then I think last week it ended up being a 4-hour even though we only recorded for the show like an hour and a half or 2 hours, but we sat there and talked afterwards for a long time. So everybody that watches, I appreciate, and I will see you guys in the next video.